This video was brought to you by GeneralPack.com, making power systems intuitive, open, and free to everyone, everywhere. Consider subscribing and supporting through Patreon.com/GeneralPack. This is the mechanism for you to support us financially so we can continue making high-quality power system video tutorials. Our corporate sponsor for this topic is AllumiaX.com from Seattle, Washington. Contact them for industrial and commercial power system studies.
Introduction to Power Factor Part 3A. In the previous part, we used our previously established knowledge to construct a power triangle, which allowed us to understand the relationships between the three types of power and the power factor. In this part, we will look at the root cause behind a low power factor in industrial and commercial power systems and its consequences. Now, before we delve into the root cause, let's first establish the difference between a leading and lagging power factor. Simply put, a facility with more inductive loads would consider to be a lagging power factor, whereas a facility with more capacitive loads would be considered as leading power factor. The word lagging and leading defines the direction of the phase angle between the apparent power and real power. Expanding upon this, we will recall that the power triangle concept. If the phase angle is positive, then it means it's a lagging power factor. This can be understood when you consider that a lagging power factor consists of inductive loads which supply reactive power to the system, resulting in a positive angle. Furthermore, if we say that a facility has a lagging power factor, then it means that the current is lagging behind the voltage by a specific angle defined as theta. On the other hand, the facility consists of capacitive loads, then it will result in a leading power factor. This can be shown on the power triangle with a negative phase angle between the apparent power and the reactive power. The word leading also signifies the fact that a current is now leading the voltage by a specific angle defined as theta angle. Now that we know the differences between a leading and lagging power factor, we can now move forward with the reasons for a low power factor in the facilities of today. There is rarely an industrial commercial facility which is devoid of any inductive loads, such as induction motors, shunt reactors, transformers, or even induction generators such as windmills. It is precisely these types of loads which require magnetic flux for performing useful work. This magnetic flux can be supplied by the reactive power of the system. Moreover, the magnetizing current required by arc lamps are another cause of a low power factor, as they require a high amount of magnetic flux to operate stably. The greater the amount of induction loads, the greater the reactive power supplied, and the greater the reactive power, the lower the power factor of the system. You might think, how bad can a low power factor be? But truth be told, there are several consequences of running a system with a low power factor. The first and foremost important reason is high utility cost. This is because a higher reactive power and a lower power factor causes an increase in overall apparent power drawn by the system and subsequently increasing the power demand of the facility. Another issue caused by low power factor is an increase in the system losses. A higher reactive power requirements draws more current, and the square of the current is directly proportional to the line losses. In addition to that, the higher the current demand would mean that a larger conductor size would be required to safely transmit power throughout the system. Furthermore, the increase in overall apparent power would mean that a kVA ratings of each equipment present in the facility would need to be increased as well. This adds unnecessary design costs to the system, which can easily be avoided with a high power factor. If we consider a generation station instead, then a low power factor would cause higher voltages due to the high amount of excitation current required in the generators to accommodate the additional line losses. To summarize it all, a low power factor can have long-term negative effects on a power system, and efforts should be made to ensure a high power factor. Now in part 3b, we will look at some of the techniques which we can use to improve the power factor. We hope that you have a continued interest in this topic and series as a student or professional, and we also hope you find this content useful and enlightening. Please consider subscribing to GeneralPack.com and becoming our patron at patreon.com/GeneralPack. GeneralPack.com, making power systems intuitive, free, and open to everyone, everywhere.